Are you looking for a personal trainer in Singapore? Why do you see rates from $10 an hour to more than $200 an hour? Today, I'll share with you some industry insights so that you can make a more informed decision on how to choose a personal trainer. Just a quick disclaimer, I do have a team, and as much as this is an advertisement, it's also not possible for us to serve everyone in Singapore. So my goal here is to help you find the right trainer for yourself. If you're new here, this is Jingjie, founder of Allset, a physio and personal training company. Now diving into the topic, when choosing a personal trainer, there are five main things to look out for. Pricing, business model, location, niche, and personality. How you prioritize these five variables is up to you, but I'll now break down each of them so that you can weigh them accurately. And the easiest to explain is location. If you're opting for house calls, you should be getting the lowest rates among all the possible options. This is because a trainer doesn't have to pay rental, and he or she simply uses whatever equipment is available. This can be in the form of your home gym, your condo gym, or fitness corner. For my company, if you don't have any equipment, we actually buy you a dumbbell set free of charge when you sign up for a package with us. The more portable stuff like foam roller and bands, we'll bring around with us. So in that sense, you don't really need much to get started. Coming back to the location, if you choose to go to a gym, just bear in mind a gym in Orchard or CBD, for example, will have higher overheads than a gym somewhere else. All this will add up, and in some cases, it'll be quite obvious you're paying at least a little bit of premium for the convenience or atmosphere. While that might sound unnecessary, it can make a lot of difference to your experience and in some cases, even performance. Even as a trainer myself, I frequent the Dempsey site simply because the environment is more resort-like and that helps with my mental health, which in return gives my client a better service. Next variable, business model. Now this actually makes more difference to the cost and your experience than most people realize. For example, a small company might not need to pay GST and corporate tax, and if they hire on a freelance basis, they don't pay CPF as well. All this can add up to a whopping 41% difference in terms of cost for a company of trainers, and some of these costs will definitely trickle down to you. On the flip side, if you engage a freelance trainer, you need to know he or she has to balance training, marketing, upskilling, career growth, etc. Beyond a certain number of hours, there will be a drop in quality or difference in experience. We trainers are after all humans, and we do get tired or mentally drained if it's too much of the same thing. Trainers with a company, as a result, might be able to provide better support and service. It really boils down to the individual trainer. More about that in a bit. For now, there's one other thing about business model, which is how trainers at the gym work. Do you have to pay gym membership? Or do you just pay the personal trainer? Or do you pay their boss? It's good to find out where this money is reinvested into. Is it education, better services, or something else? Usually, you'll be able to tell by the future plans or growth of the company. And these are useful to you because there's a good chance you stick to your trainer for a period of time. This trainer as well as the service in general should over the years have some progression. You want to keep improving different aspects of your training as well as keep your training interesting. Speaking of which, I think it's apt we talk about the next variable, niche. This simply means some trainers specialize in certain areas. Once again, we trainers are humans and we have our unique passions and interests. For example, I'm interested in running and triathlon. I also recently did some IPPT videos for our YouTube channel, and since then, I've received several personal training requests for IPPT, up to the point that I can say confidently, I'm much better at optimizing IPPT than I was a year ago. The other members of my team, on the other hand, specializes in other areas, for example, teaching safe weightlifting technique, as well as chronic health issues like diabetes, hypertension, and high cholesterol. While we all do general strength conditioning, weight loss, as well as body transformation, I think this example gives you a better understanding that there are many types of personal training out there. One thing to note is that some trainers charge a premium just because of their specialization and because they have a track record in that niche. To some people, paying for that premium is worth it, and for some people, it's not. I say that with my most neutral stance possible because right now we are going to the next variable, pricing. Apart from all the above mentioned, one key determining factor of pricing is indeed the trainer's experience and past results. For example, if you are a new trainer, there's a chance you don't want to charge too high because you want to get in a number of clients fast by providing irresistible discount, or you're not confident of the results, or you're not sure whether you will make mistakes. The other way is you join a gym and you take the pay of a junior trainer. Either way, where most people start out, they get paid less. And when they are more experienced, they get paid more. This also explains why some of the packages on Carousell are ridiculously low. On the other hand, trainers that charge the most, and I'm talking about thousands per month, often have a good track record in multiple specialties. Financially, it still makes sense for clients to invest in their service because someone who knows sports science, nutrition, and physiotherapy, for example, will not only save you costs from going to three separate services, but he or she can also help you create a more holistic plan in a shorter amount of time. With that, we've come to the most overlooked variable, personality. When you hire a trainer, you're going to be with him or her for months and even years. You guys will most likely talk about topics beyond personal training, and you'll learn to see the world through each other's perspective. To give you a concrete example, I have trouble looking for articulate trainers who can clearly communicate their technical knowledge to join my team. Part of it is because they might not want to join me, but on the other hand, it's really hard to find these guys. However, a trainer who's able to do so will probably be of more value add to you. Another concrete example is the story of the trainer, and this is because if you share similar stories, you can empathize better, you can connect emotionally, and the trainer can help you in ways other trainers can't. To me, that's something invaluable and you can't put a price to that. So at the end of the day, if you're thinking of personal training, you can split your research into these 5 variables. Weigh which one is more important to you, and then go for trial sessions before you commit to a trainer. Well, that's all for my take on how to choose a personal trainer in Singapore. If you need help on your decision, feel free to contact us. I can't promise I'll find you a trainer that fits you perfectly, but I do have some connections and I'll see what I can do. Otherwise, till next time, take care.